out how Nicolas Maduro is holding on to power and able to resist American pressure. He's given himself direct control of this land, and he's bleeding it dry. Enriching himself and buying the allegiance of the military. And it all starts with the local miners. Who, with mouths to feed at home, risk it all operating in this lawless region. We venture in 50 meters deep. It is a precarious operation.
Muchas gracias.
Inside, the miners guide us through the various levels and galleries, past evidence of a colonial thirst for gold. Along the way, I meet Darwin Rojas, who has been mining here for 3 years now. Back-breaking work in intense humidity. Everywhere you look, speckles shimmer from above.
This mine has been so productive for them because they have got 250 kilos of gold out of this mine, just to give you a sense, really, of why it's called.
Or just over 550 pounds is accurate. That's well over $10 million at global market prices, all from one single dug hole. There are dozens around us, thousands within Venezuela's mining arc. But not all that shimmers is gold, and these miners know it. These rocks need to be crushed, processed, scraped, and melted before you actually see the gold. This nugget here, $315. But it comes at a cost to the health of the miners as well as the environment. With mercury and other chemicals used to separate gold from grit, poisoning everything you see around us. But this is business, and these mills don't do it for free. And then there's an additional cost, even if the miners are scared to admit it. It's clear from what he's saying, there are the forces involved, there are the people they have to pay in order to be continuing to work in these mines, but clearly they're not prepared to tell us who they are. They have every reason to be afraid. These mines are run by a network of hooded militias called Pranes, who, according to a senior military source, enter mines to extort, steal, and silence. They do so together with complicit members of the military. They bribe to operate freely.
¿Qué tipo de presión? ¿Cómo lo hace? ¿Mata gente?
A local miner too scared to speak out about the gangs close to the mines opens up once his identity is hidden.
They mutilate people, they cut them, torture them, and the ones that speak are also tortured and mutilated. They kill them and throw them down those holes.
One active senior military source confirms what we've heard in El Callao, telling me these same groups use death squads to command obedience, battling each other and the military for control over this mining area. It's a pressure tactic of blood and bullets. I ask the miner if he blames Maduro.
¿Culpas a Maduro por esto?
I think the government has the capacity to put an end to the Pranes if it wants to do it, but they are not going to do it because they benefit from it.
This is echoed from the top. General Manuel Figuera was the former spy chief for the Venezuelan president until April the 30th, when he defected.
Maduro has knowledge of all of this and has done very little, if anything.
For years, he was part of Maduro's inner circle, with the US Treasury sanctioning him over accusations he oversaw mass torture, mass human rights violations, and mass persecution. Now, with sanctions dropped, he's speaking out about corruption at the very top, backing the U.S. assessment that Maduro's family are also profiting.
There are companies linked to Maduro's family circle who buy the gold and negotiate the extraction of the gold in the south of the country. They sell one part of it to the central bank, and the other part they take out of the country without any kind of control.
In Caracas, we find this net exchange for food, which the government then used in their subsidized food boxes. But it didn't stop there. According to a source at the Venezuelan Central Bank, 26 tons of gold were taken out of the bank to the end of April. They were put into private airplanes and a destination, Middle East and Africa. That's $1.6 billion, much of it skirting US sanctions. According to the source, several other shipments left Caracas this year to United Arab Emirates, directly and also via Uganda on a Russian plane, in exchange for euros.
Maduro is at the helm of a criminal enterprise. He has hijacked all the state's institutions to work in his service. This has allowed him to corrupt public servants and military officials in all the power structures in order to perpetuate his rule.
This matches what we hear on the streets of El Callao. Here, where gold is a standard currency, many like this gold seller are just a cog in the system, which is controlled all the way from the top. But with a river of gold running deep and the economy shrinking by half in a span of 5 years, there is little sign Maduro and his men will turn their back on this blood gold. Here, human misery goes hand in hand with environmental devastation. It's a free-for-all, a gold rush where the main winner is Maduro.
Has been addressing the Senate as the government teeters on the brink of collapse. He faces a no-confidence vote.